Welcome back, tech enthusiasts. Today, we're diving back into the captivating world of AI image generators. If you've been following my blog, you might recall my previous article where I expressed my admiration for Midjourney and Leonardo.ai. Well, guess what? They're still on my favorites list. But there's a new player in town. OpenAI has rolled out DALL-E 3, and let me tell you, it's a game changer. Today, we're going under the hood, comparing these powerhouses, and scouting for any new contenders on the horizon via API. Before we dive in, a quick hello to all the newcomers and the regulars. I'm Ilya, your guide in this tech exploration. If you find this journey enlightening, don't forget to comment, share, and subscribe. And if you enjoy the ride, hit that like button. Now fasten your seatbelts and let's get started. Remember Leonardo.ai? I've been tinkering with it and created a Python wrapper to make our lives easier. You can find this handy tool on GitHub or PyPy. It's as easy as Py to use. Just sign up, grab your API key, and you're ready to roll. With this, you can churn out images in bulk or tweak the generation parameters to your liking. Now, let's talk about the new kid on the block, DALL-E 3 from OpenAI. If you've been keeping up, you'd know DALL-E 2 didn't quite hit the mark. But DALL-E 3? It's a whole different story. To get started, create an account on OpenAI, get your API key, and you're good to go. I've also whipped up a Python wrapper for it, which you can find on GitHub or PyPy. Let's shift gears and talk about Midjourney. To be honest, it's a bit of a pain. It's only accessible via Discord, using Discord credentials, and there's no API to interact with it, plus you can't use any automation tools for it. This holds true for both Midjourney and Discord. Because of this, everything I'm about to share might violate their terms of service. I strongly advise against using it, or if you choose to proceed, do so at your own risk. Personally, I recommend waiting until Midjourney implements a web interface or API rather than trying to hack the system. That said, if you're still keen on generating images from code with Midjourney, you'll need at least two parts to extract images from it. To trigger Midjourney, we need to develop the interactions bot, which is the most critical and risky part of this process. Discord has prohibited the use of slash commands by Discord bots since 2021 and bans all user bot accounts. This means that using this bot will violate Discord's rules. However, such bots do exist. You can use a ready-made library like Discom, or since we only need to trigger a few things, it'll be sufficient to trigger a single request to Discord. Now let's dive into the second part of our thrilling journey, the Watcher bot. This little guy is our secret agent keeping an eye on the Midjourney bot's responses. You can either deploy a self-bot for this mission, or if you're feeling official, create a proper bot. I'm a fan of PyCord, but hey, choose your own adventure. When your bot is set up and ready to roll, it's time to monitor the channel for any messages and content. Voila! Your Watcher bot will now keep you updated with the URLs generated by Midjourney. You can use these to download images and incorporate them into your code. Or, if you're feeling adventurous, proceed further, grab one of the action buttons, and interact with it. Enjoy the ride! Alright folks, we've got all our ducks in a row. It's time to put our three API generators to the test. Ready? Let's get this show on the road. First things first, we need to gather the response from our trusty Midjourney Watcher bot. We can do this via a queue, a global variable, or simply parse a log. So let's whip up a function to handle this. Next, let's wrap Midjourney and Leonardo into their own cozy generation functions. One more task on our checklist, saving the image from the URL. I'll be using AI, IOHTTP and IO files for this. The final step is to bring all our methods together and feed them the same prompts. But here's the kicker. If you want top-notch results, you'll need to use different prompts for different generators. In fact, it's best to follow the style guide for each generator, so we'll use different prompts for each one. For Leonardo, prompt magic and alchemy work like a charm, but for DALL-E and Midjourney, more detailed prompts are the way to go. In example, for Midjourney, big style reference exists, which keywords and keys may be used for better results. So, why not let AI handle this task? I'll be using the ABLT MainaBot for this. It's already trained to generate prompts for Midjourney and DALL-E. I'll use the Ability Python API. So let's put it to work. And there you have it. We've got all the pieces of the puzzle. It's time to put our three API generators to the test. Let's see who comes out on top. A simple prompt like this might lead to straightforward results, such as an image of a girl in a dark dress riding a horse. But let's be honest, that's a tad boring. So, let's spice things up with an enhanced version of the prompt. The results? All the images look fantastic. Personally, I'm partial to the Midjourney image due to its realism, but that's just me. Leonardo's image, on the other hand, has a dark fantasy or game art vibe to it. The DALL-E image stays true to the prompt, but it resembles a collage and lacks a realistic touch. All in all, each image has its own charm, and the best one really depends on your needs. Cartoon style seems to be an easier task for all models. Starting from V.2, all Midjourney models lean towards more scenic and realistic outputs, resembling a cartoon movie rather than a simple drawing. If that's what you're aiming for, keep this in mind even when using the Niji model. Leonardo's image looks like a character from a casual co-op game like Overcooked, quite appealing. DALL-E's image is clear and relevant to the prompt, much like the first image. However, it lacks stylization and creativity. For more artistic results, creative prompts are the way to go. When it comes to generating something absurd, like Middle Ages art depicting suffering, I had no specific expectations. The results, however, were a pleasant surprise. The Midjourney image is rich in detail, featuring strange, terrifying robots and brave medieval humans. I found myself examining it for several minutes to take in all the details. The colors are fantastic too. Leonardo's image is quite average, a medieval landscape with robot-like creatures and perhaps some humans defending a castle. If I stumbled upon it online, I'd probably just scroll past it. The DALL-E image is much more unusual and atmospheric, reminiscent of surrealistic art. I like it despite the slightly messy background details and generation errors, but hey, that's part of the charm of Bruegel's style, right? In conclusion, all models perform well, especially with enriched prompts. On average, I still prefer Midjourney, but DALL-E 3 is indeed a game changer. It's more accurate and creative than Leonardo, but it requires careful handling. As you can see, each model brings unique details and vision to the table, such as the attention to the horse's hair or the moss on the trees. It's truly impressive. However, some details might still appear collage-like, so you need to handle them with care. And of course, don't forget to regenerate, repeat, and vary your prompts for the best results. Creating variations is a common practice in image generation, and it's a capability that all models possess. Here's how you can do it with each model. Creating variations with Midjourney is the simplest. All you need to do is pass the same prompt, or slightly different from the original, and a web link to any existing image, e.g., an image generated by Midjourney. For DALL-E, you can use any of the create variation methods. However, it's important to note that variations are currently operated by DALL-E 2, and you may experience a downgrade in the quality of your images. For Leonardo, you need to do the same thing as for DALL-E, but there's a difference. You can either reuse the seed, which may not be a good idea, or upload the initial image to Leonardo and use it as a seed. I recommend using the second approach. Remember, creating variations is a trial and error process. Don't be afraid to experiment with different prompts and seeds to achieve the best results. Happy generating! Before we delve into the results, it's important to note that variations usually don't turn out as well as regenerations with slightly different prompts. This is because the model might lose some aspects of the initial prompt, During the regeneration based on the image, which might be more significant to you, in simpler terms, it's like saying, I want something similar to what you have, but it shouldn't be the same, surprise me. Thus, it's always better to pass original or modified prompts to model also. Now, let's examine what we have. Midjourney seems to have lost the dark side of the girl, but overall it's still nice. Leonardo is the best here. It's more accurate and more relevant to the prompt, but at the same time it's slightly different from the original prompt. DALL-E, on the other hand, is not as good. It looks blurry, some details are lost, but it does have its own charm. For cartoon toast here is similar to the first try, all models work fine. Midjourney is more realistic, maybe even better related to the initial query. Leonardo is more cartoonish, with more detailed bread, while DALL-E is simplified, but still a clear and nice character. All images are good. DALL-E's level looks like DALL-E 2, but still usable. This last try is the most interesting. Midjourney is still good. Some new details were added, like the robot's helmet. But now it seems there is a war between robots and reptiloids. I knew it. Leonardo is average again. It's okay, but I have nothing to say about it. DALL-E's image now is a complete mess and the prompt is ruined, so it's a fail. But I still like it, like a way of converting normal art to surrealistic contemporary. It's a strange thing, but it is what it is. Working with AI image generators via API is fun, it's fast, it's bulk, fast enough, and it's relatively cheaper than spending your time and tokens. All APIs except for Midjourney are pretty simple to use and you can use them in your projects. Midjourney is not as simple, but it's still usable. I hope that Midjourney will release a web interface and API soon, so we'll be able to use it in our real-world projects. The experiments conducted were certainly intriguing and demonstrated the potential of these AI image generators. If you enjoyed this content, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more updates on AI technologies. Your support is greatly appreciated. Got any thoughts or questions? Feel free to drop them in the comment section below. I'd love to hear your opinions and answer any queries you might have. Stay tuned for more exciting experiments and insights into the world of AI. Until next time, keep exploring.